Hello everyone, I am Hannah, an English teacher at Virtually Fluent, and today we are going to learn the phonetic charts in English. At Virtually Fluent, we believe one of the best ways to improve and practice pronunciation is to use the phonetic chart. The phonetic chart is another alphabet in English with lots of letters and symbols that explain a certain sound in English. Today we will use this phonetic chart. First, we are going to analyze the chart so you understand it. And then you will listen to each sound in the chart so you can use this to help you improve your English pronunciation. In this chart, you can see a top part, which is orange, and the bottom part, which is blue and green. The top, orange, is vowels and the bottom is consonants. Let's start with the consonants. You can actually see most of these look the same as the English alphabet, with a few extra sounds as well. With all the consonants in English, we have two types, the blue ones and the green ones. The technical name for the blue ones is voiced sounds, and the technical name for the green ones is unvoiced sounds. What does this mean? A voiced sound means the vocal cords vibrate when you say the sound. Let's take an easy example. G, g. When I say this sound, my vocal cords vibrate. Put your hand on your throat when you say this sound and you will feel it. G, g, g. The opposite of this is an unvoiced sound, all the green letters. And these do not create a vibration in the throat. These are light, airy sounds in English. For example, s. Again, put your hand on your throat. There is no vibration. So this is the difference between a voiced and an unvoiced sound. Voiced sounds with the vibration, the blue sounds, require a lot of energy and they are very dominant sounds in English. Let's start with those. B, b. Like in black, b, black, d, d. Like in day, d, day, j, j. Like in jam, j, jam, g, g. Like in green, g, green, v, v. Like in video, v, video, v, v. Like in there, v, there, v, v. Like in zebra, v, zebra, z, z. Like in television, z, television. M, m. Like in man, m, man. M, m. Like in no, n, no. M, m. Like in pink, pink. M, pink. Y, y. Like in yes, y, yes. L, l. Like in light, l, light. R, r. like in red, red. Wuh, wuh, like in Wednesday, wuh, Wednesday. So those are all the voiced sounds, big, strong sounds. Now let's look at the unvoiced sounds. These are softer and calmer. P, p, like in purple, p, purple. T, t, like in two, t, two. Ch, ch, like in chips, ch, chips. K, k, like in camera, k, camera. Like in Friday, Friday. Like in Thursday, Thursday. Like in Sunday, Sunday. Like in she, she. Like in hello, hello. And now those are all the unvoiced sounds, so you know the correct pronunciation of all consonant sounds in English. But I want to look at one more extra thing. Let's review these two sounds, p, p, for purple, and b, b, for black. When you say these sounds, p and b, everything should be exactly the same. The tongue, the jaw, the cheeks, the face, everything should be the same. The only difference is one is voiced, strong, harsh, b, and one is unvoiced, quiet and calm, p, b, p, b. These two sounds together are called a voice pair in English. And you can see a little line that connects these two sounds together. And there are lots of examples of voice pairs in the phonetic alphabet. For example, t, d, and s, z. So now we know everything about the consonant sounds. Let's move on to the more difficult vowel sounds. The first thing to know about vowels in English is they are all voiced. So you should always feel a vibration in your vocal cords when you say a vowel in English. With vowels, we also have two different categories. We have monophthongs and diphthongs. Monophthongs are one individual sound. For example, a, apple, a, a. It's one individual vowel sound. This is a monophthong. A diphthong is two sounds connected together. For example, I. We have ah and e, I. I, for example, in Friday, Friday, I. So a monophthong is one individual sound and a diphthong is two. Let's review the monophthongs first. You can see some of these sounds have little dots next to them. The dots mean the sound is really long, and no dots means short, quick, and staccato. E, e, like in she, she, e, she. I, I, like in six, I, six. Like in good, good. Ooh, ooh. Like in Tuesday, ooh, Tuesday. Eh, eh, like in seven, eh, seven, like in information, information, like in Thursday, Thursday, or, like in door, or, door, ah, like in apple, ah, apple, like in up, up, ah, like in car, ah, car, op, like in not, op, not. So those are all of the individual sounds, the monophthongs. Let's move on to the diphthongs. Remember, these are the combination sounds. So there will always be two parts to these sounds. Ia, ia, like in hia, ia, hia. A, a, like in grey, a, grey. Or, like in tourist, or, tourist. Oi, oi, like in boy, oi, boy. O, o, like in yellow, o, yellow. Air, air, like in there, air, there. I, like in Friday, I, Friday. Ow, ow, like in brown, ow, brown. So now you know all the phonetic sounds in English. How can this help with your pronunciation? Every single word in English must have a phonetic transcription. For example, hat. If I research this word in the dictionary, I will see the phonetic transcription. This is the phonetic transcription. I can check I am using the correct pronunciation by analysing the phonetic transcription. The first phonetic sound is h, h. The second one is a, 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 and finally t, t, at, at, hat, hat, hat. So I know this is the correct pronunciation of a word. This is very useful if you see a new word in written English and you don't know the correct pronunciation. You can find the phonetic transcription and analyze each sound to check you are saying it correctly. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and turn notifications on to see lots more videos of English being used in everyday situations. You can also find us on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Instagram, where I post lots of free content to help you learn and improve your English. This is Hannah at Virtually Fluent, bringing English to life.